I bow to all the seekers of truth. Just now you were listening to a folk song which was written by a great saint called Namadeva about 1200 century. This great poet has written in this poem about asking the mother for the yoga is the union with the divine power. In many ways he has promised that he will give up all the bad relationships he has had with greed, lust, with hatred and with all other these destroying qualities which cling to human beings and make him subservient. It's very beautiful written, but the last one is so beautiful that he says that I would like to have the complete bodha. Now this bodha word is coming, as you have heard about buddha. Bodha means that you have to feel this all-pervading power on your central nervous system. It is not just a mental projection. It is not a certificate. It is not following any cult or sect or religion outwardly. But something happening on your central nervous system is bodha. And from there, there's another word which we call as Veda, which means from where Veda has come. Veda means also to know on your central nervous system. So it is not just a mental projection that I believe in it, I believe in that, I believe. But who are you? First of all, find out who you are. What are you believing? When you say, I am my eyes, my hands, my body, my. So you are not that. It is yours. So to know the reality, we have to know it on our central nervous system. In our evolutionary process, whatever we have known so far, for example, if you have to take a dog or a horse through a dirty lane, he can easily pass through, but a human being cannot. The reason is human being has evolved much more than dog or a horse, and he cannot bear the smell or the filth or the dirt of that lane. But when you become a saint, when you become a self-realizer, then nobody has to tell you that you have to be moral, you have to be compassionate, you have to be good. It just happens. And that is what has to penetrate into your own being. It has to work out and it has to make your own being like that. So it has to manifest in your personality. It is not just certifying you that you are such and such and such and such. So those people who identify themselves with this kind of artificial following ultimately discover that they have done wrong, that they have been misled, and they give up, or their children give up, or they revolt. But it's just the same. Now when we start finding that in the name of religion so many things are happening, we start even doubting if there is God or not, if there is His power or not. We start doubting everything because we think that it is the thing that our parents have followed, our forefathers have followed all the time, they spent all their lives, they have achieved nothing. So now, there must be something in it, or are we all being misled by all these theories and by all these big, big organizations that are built in? So in the essence, there is truth. In the essence, the people who came on this earth to teach us about the all-pervading power of God or God Almighty or His love, they were not false. But the falsehood came later on when people started using that for other purposes. So the principle of everything is that we have to first seek the eternal. And what is this eternal? This eternal is the all-pervading power of God's love. Everything is existing in that power. This is the power of God. Everything is created out of that power and remains in that power, like an ocean. But supposing sometimes the waves can fold it, of ignorance comes in, and in that fold people don't realize that they are completely nourished, looked after and loved by this power of God. As I say, you have to have a very open mind of a scientist. You need not come with any blind faith, or you need not come with any conceptions, but you have to just see this from the point of view as a scientist would see, like a hypothesis. And if hypothesis is proved, then you have to accept it. So if this power is looking after us, if it is nourishing us, then where did we go wrong? We have lost in the ignorance of this power. We are not conscious of this power. This power exists around us. It has given us all our body. So many things cannot be explained by medical science. For example, there are so many things, but one of them I'll tell you, that anything that goes in the body, which is a foreign body, by nature of the body, it is thrown out. But when a mother conceives a child, it is kept in the womb, it is looked after, nourished, and thrown at the right time, with a proper timing. Who does that? There are so many other things, like acetylcholine and adrenaline, these two chemicals react in a different way. They sometimes augment and sometimes relax. Doctors cannot explain. They cannot explain it, but they are honest people, so they say, we don't know. The mood of nature, we don't understand of these chemicals, what happens to them in the body. Who does that? When we say autonomous nervous system, who is this auto? Who is the one who looks after this autonomous nervous system? But in the science, they don't ask questions because there are no answers. But whatever is available, they put forward and one has to go further to see. So we have to turn our eyes to saints. To real saints, not some certified ones, but the real ones, who have felt the truth, who have talked about it, and said that there is all-pervading power of God's love. You can call it by any name, but everyone has talked about it. Now, what is that all-pervading power? It's the power that acts in our whole evolution, in all our being. It is the comforting power within us, which comforts us. It is the counseling power which counsels us, and it is the redeeming power which has made us a human being. It has also created a human being with a very special centers within us, as you see here. There are seven centers within us. These centers, on one side, look after our plexuses on the physical side, on the emotional side, on the also mental side. These exist within us, and you can see them when this power, which is told as Kundalini, which is the power of pure desire, which rises. You can see the rising of the Kundalini sometimes with naked eye, but definitely you can feel it with the stethoscope till it reaches your fontanel bone area, where you can feel the throbbing, and once it breaks, you feel the cool breeze of the Holy Ghost coming out of your own head. Nobody has to certify it. And then you start feeling this cool breeze of the Holy Ghost all around. Nobody has to certify for you. It is for you to feel it. But first, open your mind. You have to open your mind in one way, that after all, we have not reached the absolute point. Human beings have not reached the absolute point. And when we have not reached the absolute point, what is the way to reach that point? They will try to reach the absolute zero in temperature. But why not the absolute within ourselves? The absolute is the spirit which resides in the heart and is the one which is the source of joy, which is the source of truth, which is the source of divine love, which is the source of peace and bliss. So why not reach that source? But it cannot be reached through your mental effort. It cannot be reached by your emotional effort, like, I love God, and oh God, when will you meet me, I'll break my head, and all kinds of these ideas, I'm not going to take you there. Moreover, for God to lament and to suffer is not necessary. He He is your father. He is the father of all the fathers. And which father would like his child to suffer? If he loves you, and he loves, no doubt, because he's the source of all the pure love, then why will he ask you to suffer? So anybody tells you that you have to suffer for God must be wrong, or maybe there are some other intentions. You don't have to suffer anything. He has built you up very well, beautifully like this. Sometimes, of course, if you have some physical problem, some mental problem, some emotional problem, then of course you find that this happening of raising of the Kundalini takes some time. But that just is exceptional case. Mostly people get their realization. But later on, again, their mental activity starts, they start thinking about it. I have seen wherever I have programs 2 days, most of the persons first they get their realization, they'll raise their hands, they have felt the cool breeze, everything. And second day they come back and they say, Mother, I have lost my vibrations. Why? Because you have started thinking. It's a very simple, spontaneous method by which it happens. There is nothing to be done about it. It is spontaneous, as I tell you, because it's a living process. And a living process has to be spontaneous. Supposing tomorrow one of you gets realization, and you know the decoding of it, then you can give realizations to others. That's how we have to change. We talk of organizing things about ecological problems and war problems and this problem, that problem. But those who are organizing it, are they peaceful? Are they in balance? Have they got ecological balance within themselves or not? So first of all, we have to achieve it within ourselves. If we achieve it, then we will know what is the real balance, what is needed, how far we have to go. As it is, they had told me, Mother, you better not give a big lecture to them, but just give them realization, and I hope you people would like to have that. Now this song has a special meaning because it is sung by a very great poet and a very great saint who very deeply understood this all-pervading power. And when he went to Punjab, he was respected by Guru Nanak, because only a saint can recognize a saint. When he went to meet a potter, an ordinary potter, the potter was busy with his pottery, so he just looked at him and he said, "Oh, I came here to see the formless, that is the vibrations, but I see it in a form that you are." What an appreciation of another personality. No jealousies, no anger, no temper, but just an understanding that we are part and parcel of the whole. That's what you become. Once you become that, becoming is the point. That you become means you do feel within yourself another personality. You can feel another personality, and then the joy of that love is so tremendous. I have seen people now from 30 nations meeting. They are like angels. So beautiful how they meet each other, how they talk to each other, and what a beautiful race, I would say, they have created, which you see, you are surprised. They dress up like you, they are all normal, all married people, have very sane married lives, have children, beautiful children. They live so beautifully, there's not much of a change outside, but inside they are completely changed. I don't have to tell them, don't do this, don't do that, nothing of the kind. The 10 commandments within themselves are awakened and they can feel it. So for Sahaja Yoga, if you want to know, there are books, you can read them. As I always tell, that look at these beautiful chandeliers. But if you come here and there are no lights, you have to just switch on one switch and all of them come out. In the same way, if it is built in within you, it just works. You don't have to talk about it, discuss about it, just works. And it has to work out today for all of you. I was thinking of you people asking me for questions. But I would like to know, would you like to have your realization or the questions? So those who want to have realization are more, we should have realization first. What do you say? All for realization? Raise your hands. That's very good. Now what I would say then, those who have questions also, I don't want to say no to them because it's a very wide subject. I must have given thousands and thousands of lectures. and that too in English language. So there's no problem. You can get the tapes also. Apart from that, if you want to ask me questions, you can write them down and we'll answer them. So please write them down and send it, because most of you want your realization, so it is better to have your realization. If you have any questions, then you can write them down and let us know. Also, we have a clinic. We have a clinic in near Cambridgeshire, where people are treating patients. So those who are suffering from some incurable diseases like cancer, also drug addiction or anything like that, are welcome to go there. It's a very beautiful place where there are doctors who go there Saturday, Sunday, and they look after you and they'll help you. You don't have to pay anything there. Nothing has to be paid. It's all free. Those who want to go can take the address outside, they'll give you the address. You're all welcome to go there. So that's how we can minimize the work of people by separating them, like they will do the curing. Then also there are books, you can read them. Then you have questions, you can write to us. Like that, we can attend to every one of you. There is one thing, those who do not want at all self-realization, you cannot force it. It cannot be forced. You have to ask for it. As Christ has said, you have to knock. In the same way, you have to ask for it. Nobody can be forced into it. It takes hardly about 10 minutes to get your self-realization. If you don't get it today, you'll get it tomorrow. Everybody gets realization, if not today, tomorrow. It takes some time for some people, because they are sick, there's problem. It gets cured with Kundalini awakening. You don't have to take any medicines, nothing. The Kundalini itself cures you. Now how it cures you, how it works out, is all in the book. You can read it for yourself. They'll tell you, if there are doctors, they can go and meet our doctors. Now there are 7 doctors who are doing this work for you, absolutely free. I hope you are satisfied with this arrangement that we have made. You can go there in the morning, you can telephone to them, you can have your lunch there, if you want, you can stay there, and you can ask for your cure, for which you don't have to pay at all. But if you are going there, you have to take your papers of your illness, what is your illness, what is your trouble, because without that, it will be difficult for doctors to locate your problem. It's a very simple method, for which there are 2 conditions you have to. One condition is that you are not to feel guilty. Nobody has to feel guilty. We are human beings. And if we make mistakes, there's nothing absurd about it. After all, we are not gods. So we can make mistakes. But God Himself is the ocean of forgiveness. So what mistakes can we commit that He cannot forgive? He can forgive anything that we think is so bad or something that to be guilty about. You need not be guilty about anything whatsoever. At least just now you forget the past. Completely forget the past and don't think of the future. At present you have to get your realization, so you shouldn't at all feel guilty. Then second thing is that you have to forgive everyone. Many will say it's difficult to forgive, but just for saying that I forgive, it's not so difficult. Moreover, logically, if you see, that whether you forgive or don't forgive, you don't do anything. You don't do anything. It's just a myth. But when you don't forgive, you play mentally into wrong hands. So best thing is to forgive and not to play into the hands of wrong people who are going to do you wrong. So better to say in your heart that I forgive everyone. If you say that, you'll feel much lighter and you'll feel much happier. I know the music was rather loud, but it helps to clear out your limbic area, I find. Sometimes it's very good. Especially for young people, they love it because they are used to loud music nowadays. But it helps to clear the limbic area which might have been clogged. So some people might have felt it was rather loud, they should have made it a little slower. But it is good from the Kundalini point of view, it helps you. So may God bless you all. Should we take out our shoes, please? Because this Mother Earth helps us a lot.